Hello students, I am Debojyoti Ghosh. Today I am going to discuss the fertilization process in human. Before fertilization, capacitation of spermatozoa is very important. Where it happens? It happens mainly in vagina. How? A decapacitation factor of epididymis is already present there. So in vagina, that decapacitation factor is diluted. Then thinning of cholesterol layer over acrosome cap is done. Then influx of Ca double plus ion occurs. So this causes the rapid tail movement in spermatozoa. Now the sperm has the capacity to fertilize ovum. Now follow the next process. So this is corona radiata. This layer is zona pellucida. Note it down. And this is ulema. These are the cortical vesicle with cortical granules. It's a Golgi derivative mainly. And here fertilizing anti-fertilizing reaction occurs, and here acrosomal reaction occurs. Now let's see how it happens. First, hyaluronidase enzyme and CPE, that is corona penetrating enzyme, dissolves the cementing site of the corona radiata. Okay, this process is called the approximation of spermatozoa. It's a chemotactic reaction. The next step is fertilizing anti-fertilizing reaction. So fertilizing is present in the ovum. It's a binding glycoprotein, and a part of zona pellucida of ovum combines specifically with anti-fertilizing of sperm. What is anti-fertilizing? Anti-fertilizing is acidic protein of sperm to prevent the hybridization. Okay. Then acrosomal reaction happens. In acrosomal reaction, the acrosome releases sperm lysine. What is sperm lysine? Sperm lysine is a combination of three enzymes. One is hyaluronidase, which dissolves corona radiata. Okay. Next, CPE, corona penetrating enzyme. I have previously told you, it dissolves the cementing cells of corona radiata. Okay. And next is acrosin. Another name is zonalysin. It also dissolves zona pellucida. Okay. Note that the corona radiata and zona pellucida remains present till embryo is present in the fallopian tube to prevent implantation. Okay. It's a very important concept. This acrosomal reaction is a local reaction. Okay. Next is fertilin reaction. What is fertilin reaction? It's a part of spermatozoa present in the plasma membrane. Okay. Fertilin of spermatozoa binds with fertilization cone of ovum. This ulema breaks and nucleolus along with proximal centriole of sperm enters into ovum. Clear? After entry of one sperm nucleus and proximal centriole into the ovum will not allow any other sperm to enter. This phenomena is known as blocks to polysperm. How? The process involves exocytosis of cortical granules, depolarization in ulema, and zona reaction, that is formation of fertilization layer. See how it happens. First, influx of sodium ion causes the depolarization of ovum. This is known as first and fast block to polyspermy. Okay. Next, thereafter, Ca double plus influx occurs and cortical granules are released. So this is the exocytosis of cortical granules. Clear? This is known as second and slow block to polyspermy. Okay. Then the final cortical reaction, that is zona reaction, happens. How? Between this ulema and zona pellucida, these two changes into fertilization membrane. This is zona reaction. Now the fertilization process is complete.